I finally broke up with Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code is not even installed on my machines anymore, and I only use my favorite new IDE, Zed. It's incredibly lightweight, it doesn't need any plugins, it does everything I do in Visual Studio Code, and it has a special feature that I'm going to show you in a second. Zed is a super lightweight IDE. I'm talking zero plugins, thank God. And also has just some themes that are really, really good and make it really easy. Why I like Zed over everything else right now is I am a simple person. If you've seen in the past, I've done two videos on Visual Studio Code extensions that I have installed, and there's only four of them. And then one of those is a theme. And the only reason I have those extensions is because I need those for syntax highlighting, such as TypeScript or Prisma or Astro or MDX or whatever it might be. And then some of those features are already built into Zed. So I don't have to worry about those. So this is a TypeScript project. Of course, you get all the same IntelliSense, so you can choose the things that you need. You, of course, also get squiggly lines when you aren't doing the correct thing, such as this input is never read, so why are we even using it? And of course, if you use the incorrect types, you get TypeScript errors with quick fix as you do with Visual Studio Code. So nothing really special there. Then, of course, you've still got search in projects so you can find the file that you need. So let's say I need to be in here. And they offer a Vim mode for the Vim users out there. So if you press Control Shift P and go to settings and open settings, you can add Vim mode with a single line of code. And you can set this to true, and then it will run just like Vim does when you open a file. So if you're into that and you want kind of an IDE, you can do that right out of the gate. Of course, you can have your key maps set to whatever you want. They have VS Code, they have Atom, JetBrains, Sublime, TextMeet, or nothing. I have mine set to Visual Studio Code because they are ingrained in my head. So it's really super lightweight for me, which is perfect. I like lightweight IDEs. And I haven't opened Visual Studio Code since I started using Zed, which was when they went to open beta. But this is not the best feature. The best feature is their collaboration tool. So let's take a look at how that works. So as you can see here, Joe has invited me to a session, and you get to choose whether or not to accept the session or decline it. And then once that happens, you actually get tossed into their project. So as you can see here, we now have a different project in the top left-hand corner of the screen. You can see that up there. And then I click this button up here, which just unfollows Joe for a second. And now the project has loaded. As you can see, I'm now inside of his Create Next Act project, and we can talk about whatever bugs we have, and he can type and I can see those. So he's gonna type some stuff here in a second. He's just gonna delete some code out, and then he will then add some code in. This makes it really easy for collaboration. As you can see, I'm not really bothered by the fact that he's clicking around and changing some code, but it allows us as developers to peer program quicker. I don't have to set up a call with Joe. He can ask me the question, and then I can go ahead and use it. He's saying hello, and now he's typing some stuff in to be funny, and that's just typical Joe. But you can see that this is really useful. Then we can move on to a section when he can actually share. So now Joe is going to go ahead and share his screen, and now I am seeing what he is seeing through this Zed application. He can now do whatever he needs to, and I can see it all work. He clearly found a bug here where he forgot to start his own server. So now he can go back and look at his code, and when he looks at his code in Zed, he will be able to show me that as well. So now it flips back and I can see him typing away, and I'm like, oh, he's doing something here, loading up his example. Okay, now he can go back to his browser and he can refresh the page, and now it works as expected. So this is one of my favorite features because it allows me to just drop into a voice call and he can start coding immediately, and we can get full context without having to try and troubleshoot via a Google Meet where I can see his screen and I want to type something, but I can't because I have to ask him to do it, and vice versa. So you've made it all the way to the end of the video. If you did enjoy it, click this button right here. It will be a nice video that YouTube algorithm has chosen for you. And of course, if you're not subscribed, click this button right here. It's crazy that you're not already there.